नमस्कार, आई एम प्रोफेसर पी बी गोळे, एम ई पी स्केटेचम कॉलेज नासिक, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स, एस वाय बी कॉम, सेमिस्टर 4, कॉस्ट एंड वर्क अकाउंटिंग सेकंड, चैप्टर सेकंड, लेबर कॉस्ट रिम्युनरेशन एंड इंसेंटिव। टॉपिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन टाइम रेट एंड पीस रेट सिस्टम एंड मेथड्स ऑफ पीस रेट सिस्टम। In the previous lecture, we have studied piece rate system. After this, in this lecture, we will study the methods of piece rate system. Methods of piece rate system, also known as methods of piece work wages. First method, straight piece rate. Under this method, workers are paid wages at a fixed amount per unit of product manufactured irrespective of the time taken to produce it. The piece rate wages under this method is very simple. The worker receives a flat rate of pay per unit of output. Formula A. Wear rate per unit is known. Calculate of piece rate wages where rate per unit is given. Total earning is equal to number of units into rate per unit. Second, calculate piece rate wages where standard hour rate is given. Total earning is equal to standard hour of work produced into rate per standard hour. Underproduce may be jobs, operations or another convenient units in term of which product is expressed. A rate of payment fixed for the unit produced is known as the piece rate. The advantages and disadvantages of piece rate system, which are mentioned above, are generally associated with the straight piece rate system also. Under this scheme, the rate per piece or the rate per standard hour of production is increased as the output level rises. Second, piece work with guaranteed time rate. This is to safeguard worker earning when there is our daily shortage, tool breakdown, etc., which make it possible for worker to earn more. It is straight piece rate system. No minimum wages is guaranteed to a worker who is paid according to output, but in this case a minimum wages based on time rate for 8 hours is guaranteed. When the piece rate earning are less than time rate earning, the worker will be paid at time rate earning. But when the piece rate earning are higher than time rate earning, he will be paid at piece rate earning. In short, the worker will be paid time rate earning or piece rate earning, whichever is higher. This is safeguard worker earning when these are daily shortage, tools breakdown, etc., which make it possible for worker to earn more. Labor cost per unit decrease with the increase in production until piece rate earning exceed the guarantee. Therefore, the labor cost per piece remain constant. This system has the same advantages as straight piece rate system. In addition, the worker is not unduly penalized when his piece work earning are low through circumstances beyond his control. Disadvantages of this method are also similar to straight piece rate system, except that the cause insecurity the worker is avoided. Last method, differential piece rate. Under strength piece rate method, a flat rate per unit is paid for the entire output produced. Naturally, the incentive for higher production decline. The differential piece rate system seeks to overcome these disadvantages by paying at different rates for a different level of efficiency reflected in the output. Consequently, an efficient worker is induced to increase his level of efficiency. This method has the many variances, such as Taylor differential piece rate system, incentive plan, Halsey premium plan, etc. Next, difference between time rate systems and piece rate system. First difference point, basis of worker. In time rate system, worker is paid on the basis of time spent in the factory. In piece rate system, worker is paid on the basis of work done in the factory. Second, work done. In time rate system, work done is not considered. In piece rate system, time spent is not considered. Third point, extra payment. In extra payment for overtime work is generally paid to the worker in time rate system. Piece rate system, no question of overtime wages arise under this method. Point 4, useful of method. Time rate system, in this method is useful where quality of work is most important. In piece rate system, this method is useful where quantity of work is most important. Fifth, trade union. In peace time rate system, trade union favor this method because no distinction is made between efficient and inefficient worker. In peace rate system, trade union generally oppose this method because here distinction is made between efficient and inefficient worker. 6. Complete the work. In time rate system, tool and equipment are carefully handled by worker because there is no hurry to complete the work. In piece rate system, to get more and more wages, workers are in hurry to complete a work. It may result in damage to tools and equipment. Point number 7, minimum wages. In time rate system, minimum day wages are guaranteed. In piece rate system, day wages are not guaranteed. Point number 8, incentive. Time rate system, no incentive are given under this method. In piece rate system, incentive are given to efficient workers under this method. Point number 9, certainty. Time rate system, idle time may be increased in this method. Strict supervision and control is necessary under this method. In piece rate system, there is no need of strict supervision and control. Point number 10, strict supervision. Strict supervision and control is necessary under time rate system. In piece rate system, there is no need of strict supervision and control. Point number 11, idle time. In time rate system, idle time may be increased in this method. In piece rate system, idle time cannot arise under this method because all workers are in hurry to complete this work. Last, extract labor cost. In time race system, exact labor cost cannot be determined to so difficult in sending tender and quotations may create. In piece race system, determination of exact labor cost is possible, so preparation of tenders and quotation become quite easy. In this difference, one point is missed. Point number 8, incentives.